Welcome to IT Free Training's video on modifying local groups using group policy preferences. If you watched our last video on group policy restricted groups, you would have learned how to use restricted groups to control local group membership for clients in your company. The same results can be achieved using preferences. This video will show you how to use preferences effectively to configure local groups. Group policy preferences can also be used to fix previously made mistakes in local group creation. Group policy preferences offers a lot of control and flexibility for local user and group management. For starters, you can create a local user or group. Once the user or group is created on the local computer, it is retained even if the group policy is no longer being applied to that computer. The group policy may no longer be applied if the user or computer account has been moved or if the group policy has simply been removed or disabled. Group policy preferences has a replace option, which is used to recreate a user or a group. A word of warning with this option, though. This will essentially delete the user or group before recreating it. Since the user or group is being deleted and recreated, this will mean the SID will change. If you used that user or group for, say, file permissions, once the user or group has been deleted, its permissions will no longer be valid. If you need to create or change the membership of a group, you are better off using the update option. When using the update option, if the user or group does not exist, group policy preferences will create it. If, on the other hand, it does exist, group policy preferences will simply update the membership. This means that the SID used will be retained. As you can see with our demonstration, when updating a group, you can remove all users and group memberships, essentially allowing you to start again. The last option, Delete, allows you to delete a user or group from the local computer. This is a useful option if you want to perform a cleanup on the clients in your domain. In the last video, I looked at restricted groups, which can be used to achieve the same result as group policy preferences. If you decide to use restricted groups and group policy preferences together, the point to remember is that if a local group is being controlled by restricted groups, group policy preferences will not be able to modify the group. This means you will only be able to use one system. If you attempt to use the two, group policy preference options will be ignored. I will now change to my Windows 7 computer to look at how to configure group policy preferences to manage local groups. First, I will open the Local User Manager from the Start menu. If I look at the local groups on this computer, you can see a group has been created called Audit Software. This was created on each local computer to allow the company audit software to run. The problem with this group is that if I open it, you will notice that the domain admins group has been added to this group. In order to get the company audit software to run in a hurry, a decision was made to add the domain admins group to this local group. This gives the audit software more access than is required and is poor practice. This is a good example of a situation that happens way too often in IT. In order to get a job completed on time, some poor decisions get made in haste. Group policy preferences can be used to fix poor implementations such as these. To do this, I will open Group Policy Management from the Start menu. To make the change, I will edit the New York policy found under the New York OU. To add a local user or group, I will open Computer Configuration, Preferences, and Control Panel Settings, and then open Local Users and Groups. In here, you can add local users and groups at the computer level. By using group policy preferences, notice that if I expand down into user configuration, the same options for local users and groups are available. This is one of the advantages of using group policy preferences compared with using group policy restricted groups. Restricted groups can only be at the computer level. To create a new group, right-click the blank area and select the option New Local Group. At the top, you can choose the action for the group. It is important to select the right option here. Create will create the group if it does not already exist. Replace will effectively delete the group if it exists and then create a new group. Update will create the group if it does not exist or use an existing group if it does exist. The delete option will remove the group if it exists. In this case, I will use the update option as I want to make some changes to the group rather than delete or create a new group. This will ensure that the SID for the group does not change. The next step is the group name needs to be entered. A useful feature with the update option is that you can also change the name of a group. In this case, I will change the group name to Audit Software Version 2. Next, I will enter in a description for the group. Since I am using the User Configuration section of Preferences rather than Computer Configuration, there are some additional options for the current user. In this case, I will add the current user to the group. Current user refers to a user that is logged into the computer when the group policy is applied. These three radio buttons for the user are not available in the computer side of Preferences. In this case, since I am effectively cleaning up a mistake from before, I will select both the options on the right, Delete All Member Users and Delete All Member Groups. This will ensure that the local group is empty before I add any more members to it. At the bottom, I can add which users and groups I would like this group to have. In this case, I will add a user account I created called Domain Audit Service. This user account will be used with the audit software rather than the domain admins group. Once added, I will next select the Common tab. Notice that I can tick the option Item Level Targeting. Once I press the Targeting button, notice all the different options I now have for targeting. All these can be used to decide which criteria is being used for creating or modifying a group. For example, you could create a group if certain software was created on the computer. Another option to use when undergoing cleanups is the Apply Once and Do Not Reapply. This will ensure that once the setting for this group policy has been applied, it will not be applied again later on. Normally, a group policy setting will be reapplied when the group policy is refreshed. Configuring this option will ensure that once the policy has been applied, it will not be applied a second time. In this case, this is a good option to have on. This will allow the group policy to make changes to the existing local group. Once the changes have been made, additional changes can be made by software or the administrator without fear of these changes being erased later on when group policy is refreshed. Now that I have configured the settings, I will now exit out of group policy management and then log off. Once I have logged off, I will log back in again. This will allow group policy for the user to be reapplied. You could also run GP update to apply the changes. However, since I have added the current user to the local group, the user's token needs to be recreated to include membership of this group. For this reason, a log off is required. To check that changes were made successfully, I will now open the local user manager from the start menu. If I go back into Groups, notice that the Audit Software group has changed its name to Audit Software Version 2. If I open the properties for this group, notice that the two users, Domain Audit Service and Trainer, have been added. The user account that I'm currently logged in with is Trainer. You can see how powerful group policy preferences can be for local group membership. Thanks for watching this video from IT Free Training, just one of the free videos available for the Group Policy course, part of the Active Directory course. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.